welcome. You're listening to Under the Radar, brought to you by Fixed Frequency. Blah, blah, blah.
Now I gotta move mine back.
And we're back.
We're back, round two.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you too, buddy.
It's been a while since January.
Post-coronavirus.
Yeah, man. I didn't want to talk about it because it's like, obviously, that's the only thing in the world going on right now.
Yeah, yeah.
But fuck it, we'll get it out of the way. What have you been up to, man?
I took 2 weeks off.
Nice.
I did mostly nothing. I drank some
as
beers.
You should.
I put some drywall up in the basement.
Oh, nice.
I listened to some records, and I spent a week watching children.
Self-care. Everything except for the drywall and the watching children. Should have had them do it.
Right?
More record and...
Yeah, you're never too young to try laying drywall. I mean, it's just knives and you know, drills and shit.
Drills character.
Kid stuff.
Yeah. I act like I'm hard, but as a kid, I was like, no, I'm gonna go play with, like, action figures.
Oh, yeah, I played
and
with action figures.
And have a hissy fit if someone made me do anything. Yeah. Like, mowing the lawn for the first time at, like, age 10, like, was, like,
Whoa, age 10 mowing the lawn? Son of a bitch, I was doing that at like age fucking 7.
3.
Probably before that, like.
But you've seen, I can't even walk around your house without like tripping over, so. My foot in the lawnmower.
I don't see you as that big of a fucking cartoon character.
Oh, that means a lot. I do. I need to work on my self-image. Well, that's cool, man. I've been quarantining. Pabst Blue Ribbon. Don't sponsor us. I've been, is it a quarantine? Is that the right way to say it? I've heard
self-isolating?
Like, okay.
Is that the...
Yeah.
Because, I mean, quarantining, I would think would be, like, if you actually are sick or think you're sick.
Oh, okay.
I would think self-isolation is just, like,
taking care
let's
of
not
business.
Get sick. Let's not get sick.
Yeah. Which, that's all I've been doing for the last, year. So, so nothing new.
I've been self-isolating since 2009. I don't have a problem with this.
Yeah. Well, we got that talk. Ah, fuck it. Let's dive into conspiracy theories, man.
Where do you think coronavirus came from?
Too many people have been getting into flat Earth. So nah, dude.
I've seen some crazy conspiracy theories about this. And honestly, I'm a guy who loves his conspiracy theories. But I can't handle these ones. I'm just right now I feel like I'm one of those guys that's just like, yeah, trust the government. But I mean, really, they're not telling you to do anything stupid. They're just telling you to stay the fuck home so you don't get sick.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand where the, you know, they're taking your civil liberties and freedoms away. I'm like, well, they're
coming for our guns. That's what it is.
I knew you were going there. You were going there.
They should do this every fucking flu season.
Right? Just go on lockdown for 2 weeks.
The common cold? I hate getting the common cold.
Every April, I'd say just, let's do this.
Yeah. From October till when it's nice out.
Then, out of fucking nowhere, I'll have to redo the last album.
Why did save up?
What?
Actually, he hesitating there to be like,
nah.
Thinking about, let me get my face mask first.
Right.
What else, man?
I'll just spray it down with Lysol after.
Dude, that is, you have Lysol?
Right? Totally. Spray it on some bread and have a sandwich after. Ow!
That better be from the joint.
Yeah. Yeah. Ugh. You know what happens when I smoke a joint. Fuck.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
I might have to not smoke that, actually.
Okay. Okay, how many ashes?
Yep.
Breathe. Would you like some?
Oh,
maybe you should have a sip of some Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Yeah, don't sponsor us. Your cool, crisp beer that's super cheap and also now available in Canada is just so great. It's like it's cleaning my insides out. Ah.
It was not in Canada?
I could never find the shit. I'm sure it was in Alberta, and I'm sure it was in fucking Ontario.
Oh, like a real province.
But, yeah, you know, Saskatchewan's about 20 years behind the rest of the world.
At least we ain't Manitoba.
I'll give you that. You hear that, Matt? You hear that, Matt? Guy I used to work with at the Barbie.
Ah.
He's
Manitoba.
Yeah, I can't remember where it is. I want to say Carberry or something.
Sounds made up.
doesn't exist.
Never heard of it. It's probably not real.
Yeah. I'm telling you right now, Matt, if you're listening to this, you must defend Carberry. Kerberry? Damn it, tell us the name of your town, Matt.
Cranberry.
Zombie. Was that a good impression?
That was good. That was good. Respectful.
All right.
Better than that cover that came out recently. I don't remember what band.
What? Really?
Someone covered it, yeah.
Oh, let me guess. Like Disturbed or something did it?
I think so.
I don't know. They've been doing covers lately. They've been terrible
since... Trailer Park Metal.
Yeah, they've been... Well, I guess I shouldn't say they're terrible. They're a good band. I just don't like their music. Yeah.
Volbeat. You like Volbeat, don't you?
I could go either way on those guys. I won't buy an album, but I can listen to them without, like, fucking hawking up a loogie and going, this sucks.
I can't list all the Trailer Park bands. You know what I mean? Yeah, Five Finger Death Punch
is the one that I just can't tolerate. I just can't do them.
The one I can, for whatever reason, Old Kid Rock.
Oh, hell yeah,
with
man.
The ball, man.
I had the fucking, I can't even remember what the album was called. It was just him with the cigar there. Fuck.
Yeah, Scott, like Cowboy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, that album was unbelievable. I mean, to this day, it actually almost, some of it still holds up.
My hair is curly because I had braids in earlier today, and I was listening to Kid Rock.
The Kid Rock.
In a trailer park. Holy shit, actually.
Oh, I forgot your brother lives in a trailer park. Man, the only thing missing from that was, like, I don't know. What's the only thing missing from that? Like,
I don't know. He's got a gut now. If you haven't noticed.
Is anybody missing teeth? Besides Maddie.
Oh, yeah, true.
Because I'm sure a kid's going to lose teeth, right?
Yeah. No teeth, and she's kind of like Mr. Leahy.
How the hell does a...
I am the juice box.
Oh, I like it.
I am the Kool-Aid jammer.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
I like it.
What else, man? So I don't have fucking like an aux cord or a CD player in my shitty car.
Well,
so I have to listen to radio, so that sucks.
What do you have in the car?
For music?
Just anything. Like, do you have a tape deck or something?
Tom Petty's stuck in it, respectfully.
Oh.
Rest in peace.
There is nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, that's like...
Does it at least work?
My alternator fucking broke. I don't know the word for it. My alternator no work no more. car no run. Me get car towed, fixed. Money, cash, under table.
Oh! And, car now go?
Car go.
Car now go, but no music
go.
In car.
I started it. Tom Petty, Learning to Fly, started playing. It's like, damn. Turned the car off. No more Tom Petty. But it was like he came for a visit to say things.
Nice.
Say like, Kane, your alternator's okay.
Just had
like,
to
I
let,
needed that.
Just had to let you know. Nothing wrong
it's
with
like
that.
Like anything else, I could really. I'm in a really weird spot in my life. He's like, no, alternator's fine. But Tom, my light, and then I. You just gotta take it as it is, man. Anyways, so I listen to fucking radio, and radio stations in Canada are like forced to play Canadian bands. So I listen.
Yeah.
I'm not complaining. Tragically hip. I wasn't.
Oh,
I wasn't. I didn't respect them.
Oh.
Not that I didn't respect them. I didn't.
You just didn't listen to them.
I knew this. The hits and stuff, and I was just like, okay, and then, like, I got right into it. I'm not a singer, but, like, my singing voice, I feel like I could sing, like, Gordon.
Yeah, you know, it's funny, because, like, Gord Downie's voice is, like, to me, really, really good, but in the later years, he started doing some fucking weird stuff with his voice.
Mm-hmm.
He just started going, like, I'm gonna sing off-key for fun. I'm Gord motherfucking Downie. Like
Canadian icon. He
oh,
it.
Dude, I love the hip. I've been into them since I was 10. Weirdly enough, I heard like New Orleans is sinking,
mm-hmm.
and still to this day that riff, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
I actually got away with playing Fireworks in like the last show.
Oh, yeah,
nice. Like that is
it's getting taken down now.
To this day, my favorite hip song, and it hasn't been taken down.
We'll be over and done with the adventure you've gone. You won't be coming home tonight, because you're dealing with a man at the end of his rope. And I'll be swinging for the fences on a prayer and a hope. There'll be no celebrations or banner libations, just a sad and lonely wife. You want the glory, respect and care. You want the story of the ill fame that you spill. Cause it's a Midwest overcoat, and it's begging to be felt. And if I'm not God, where did you will?
Lucky cat, yeah.
found this website called Spreaker to put the radio show on. It's like a podcast site or a radio show site,
don't
whatever.
Don't give us money.
Yeah, don't sponsor us, Spreaker. We don't use your fine service or products at all. And the fine people at Spreaker also don't put your radio shows up on YouTube like I have had the hell of a time doing. Ooh, excuse me. That was the Pabst Blue Ribbon Don't Sponsor Us coming up. But, yeah, I've had a hell of a time, as you know, trying to get the radio show on YouTube. They don't take the show for some dumb reason or some copyright bullcrap.
Yeah, shit, I gotta stop nodding on a radio show. Anyways.
But, yeah, man, this place, they just put it up.
Damn. Doing the fucking dirty work.
Yeah.
Our boys at,
Spreaker.
Don't Spreaker. I haven't slept in, 24 hours.
Yeah, that's... I actually feel legit bad for having you here, but we need to do this.
Dude, I'm glad to be here, and, like, we are just... Schedules sometimes don't... At least I show up, unlike your band, but...
well, they're two provinces away, Kane.
Make a fucking effort.
Well, actually...
FaceTime jam. So, Canadian bands, man... Our Lady Peace.
No, how about we talk about the compilation album?
I'm getting to something here, man.
All right.
Our Lady Peace, Bare Naked Ladies.
Mm-hmm.
Think of like every bigger Canadian band. Fuck, those are the only three. I had a list, bro.
That's it?
But,
Gob?
That's it. There's more. But like, the Canadian singers always have a like weird voice, and they like Nickelback. It's like, you either love them or hate them. Like, I've never ever heard anyone be like, oh, like, Our Lady Peace is all right, or Tragically Hip is all right. It's always like...
They're either good or bad.
Gods, or like, the singing voice is fucking weird.
Yeah.
Bare Naked Ladies, I'm really into. They're just like, I don't know.
Their older stuff was pretty good. You know what's weird? I like their middle stuff. Like... First couple albums weren't that good, short of, like, the Old Apartment Song.
Mm-hmm.
That one's just etched in my fucking heart forever. But, I don't know, they just, some of their songs are just, like, too novelty to me.
Pinch Me whenever I hear that.
Oh, me too, man. That one should be a novelty song, but it's just not. It's just a good song. It's
written so well.
Yeah, right?
And story.
Like, Gob is one of those for me. Like, everybody's all like, oh, Gob's fucking
awesome. I didn't know
they were
Canadian.
Oh, yeah. I want to say they're from, like, BC, but I have a feeling it's probably more like Ontario or something. I don't know. Everybody's from either BC or Ontario. The only cool punk band that's not is fucking SNFU from Alberta.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah. Like, name one kick-ass cool, like, huge punk band or any band from Saskatchewan besides Widemouth Mason.
Can't think of any off the top of my head. That's also because I'm high.
Well.
And I'm sleep deprived, and I'm drinking a Red Bull for the first time in over...
Over a year?
Yeah, almost 2 years. Almost made the 2 years.
Really?
Nah, a year and a half.
I was going to say, how long have you not lived here? Marlene's only been here a year.
I was like living with you in like the fall, that fall. So, like, October 2018, and I haven't had a pop either, but I came over here, and we're talking, and I was not falling asleep. I was just, like, fucking zombie. I still am. I gotta chug this sugar-free Red Bull. Don't sponsor it. Really don't, because, like, that would be too much money, and, like, cocaine, and hookers, and...
The endless piles of cocaine and boobs we would be into.
All that Red Bull money. Yeah. Oof.
Ah... As much as I'd love to ruin my life that way.
Did you say boobs?
Oh, totally.
Not woman, just like, just a fucking.
You could drown yourself in man boobs. I don't care.
No, like, just like silicone boobs.
Oh, like, are you talking about
like a ball pit of titties, man?
Like the dream sequence from 40 Days and 40 Nights when he's just dreaming and he's flying through the sky and all of a sudden he comes over this hill and it's just like a field of bouncing, waving titties.
Damn, I haven't seen that, but, like, that's exactly what I'm thinking.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mine sounded more terrible in my mind, like, you're, like, tripping on acid and, like, what the fuck, a girl should think it.
I don't like acid, so, well, I mean, I try
shrooms,
not to, yeah.
Cough syrup.
All right. Yeah. I do pills. You take a couple of Benylin night times during the day when you're not sick, if you just got nothing to do. You are rubber man. You are walking around the house and you are literally made of rubber. You might even be floating. You don't know. You're on fucking Benelin.
Don't sponsor. Dude, I'm trying to get that fucking money tonight.
I don't think we've ever done a show where we've literally tried to get anyone to sponsor us. We just kind of say something and then go, don't sponsor us.
I'm trying, dude.
Oh, you're trying?
Making an effort, man.
Hmm. I literally have reached out to Pabst Blue Ribbon. I have sent them emails. I have Facebooked them. I've tweeted them.
They're going to the junk.
They don't give a shit.
Yeah, they're like...
They don't give a shit about our crappy punk rock show.
Yeah, Kane's got to get shingles on his dick at least two more times before anybody gives a fuck.
Yeah, no, exactly. That, by the way, that was a hit story. People loved your shingle story.
jobs to be found. Sounds like some things in you might have changed. We all mess up once, just don't do it again. Go back on your work, then turn on your breath. Burning everybody, wish you could make it home. You got fed up with the town.
Of course they listened to that one, so I should have known. I don't know. Ah! Tells everyone. I don't know why everybody knows, but like, yeah, so there's like girls, I'm trying to mac, and they hear this story, and they think it's funny. But it's not.
It's fucking hilarious, man.
Anyways,
you're getting tail from
this. You're probably wondering how I'm doing. Nerve pain's gone, but the scars, ugh.
Oh.
Shouldn't have picked at him.
Fuck, Harvey Dent cock. Yeah. Again.
It's not bad. I've been jerking off with bio oil. Is that too personal?
Are you going to tattoo half of it purple? You really should.
It's a bunch of different colors, if we're being honest. The girl that I thought I, like, the
so it's
main
road
girl
worn?
From that story. What's that, sir?
Your dick is now road worn. It's like an old catcher's
mitt.
It was
mitt. Like that before. Now it's like a Saskatchewan road.
Old catcher's mitt, just...
No, it's just Saskatchewan road. Just vroom,
vroom. Yeah, you don't know what's going on there.
Yeah, anyway, so yeah, that main girl from the story, I guess I haven't seen you since I told
you. Yeah, when did we do this? It was just before the coronavirus outbreak. Like,
oh,
fuck,
yeah.
Like maybe like
maybe that's what it was. I'm patient zero. It just like
well, I didn't have it.
Forget
so.
The bath theory. It just like started on my dick.
Kane's dick started coronavirus. We're gonna start a new hashtag on this bitch. Kane's dick started coronavirus.
Started a lot of
where
viruses.
Are you? Where are you listening, Drew? Let's start a movement on Twitter.
His new one is something I heart ANW MBBW.
Oh, I see.
Just goes hand in hand.
Well, I did reply to him. I think it was last night.
I went on Twitter for the first time in like ever today, and I seen that, and then I was like, oh, are you coming over? Or Colin was like, come over, dude. And then he
I invited him over.
He thought I said something like he's going out for a smoke, and he's like, no. And then I was like, I seen that, and I'm like, fucking my brain is fucked because I've been up. And I was like, oh, maybe Colin meant to tweet me. And then he came back in, and then he was like, no, yeah, you told me to come over. And I was like,
yeah,
dude, you just said you didn't. But I'm fucking, maybe I'm hearing shit. Maybe I'm thinking things.
Oh.
thinking things and thinking I said them or saying things. I don't know.
Either way, Drew is more than welcome to come here anytime and fuck
anybody,
with,
man.
Like,
let's
this,
get fucking Kino on here. Let's fucking,
oh, yeah.
Dude, let's get an escort and just have her on here.
You know what?
Just talking.
Covered with-